In this video, we're going to discuss a few problems in which we will differentiate the inverse trigonometric functions. So the first function is going to be the arcsine of 3x squared. So as a side note, I'm just going to provide a few functions that we will need and the derivatives of them. Okay, so the derivative of arcsine of x is going to be 1 over square root 1 minus x squared. The derivative of arccosine of x is going to be similar, except there's a negative sign, minus 1 over 1 minus x squared inside the root. And the derivative of arcsecant of x is going to be 1 over absolute value x multiplied by the x squared minus 1 inside a square root. Okay? Okay, so now let's differentiate this. So the derivative of this is going to be, of course, you're going to follow the chain rule, right? Because you're going to first differentiate the arcsine, and then you're going to differentiate the 3x squared after that. And make sure that you understand in the chain rule, everything is multiplied. So all the steps you take, you have to multiply them, okay? All the differentiation steps that you have to multiply. So first, we're going to differentiate the arcsine. So the arcsine is going to be 1 over square root 1 minus, now here be careful, because it's not x squared. Because what you're squaring is not the x now, you're going to square 3x squared, right? So you have to put the 3x squared and then square it. And now you're going to differentiate the inside, which is going to be 6x, right? Times 6x. So that yields you 6x over 1 minus, and you're going to square everything there, right? So 9x to the fourth. Okay, so it's going to be, so now, so down the next part, in the second example, we're going to differentiate the arcsecant of x squared. So the derivative of this is going to be, we're going to follow this identity for the derivative. So we're going to get 1 over x squared inside an absolute value, and then make sure that you understand you're not going to square the x, you're going to square the x squared here, right? So you're going to put the x squared like that and then square it, minus 1, and then the derivative of the inside. The derivative of the inside is going to be 2x, right? So that's going to give you, and notice that x squared in the absolute value is just x squared, right? Because we don't need the absolute value symbol, really. Because no matter what the value of x, and well, as long as it's greater than 1, okay, as long as it's greater than 1, then we'll be all right. Okay, so, yeah, I should say here, the absolute value of x greater than 1. Okay, so that's a constraint, because if it's let's say less than 1, then obviously it's not possible, right? Because if it's 1, you will get a 0. You cannot divide by 0. If it's less than 1, you will have a negative result inside the square root, also not defined, right? Undefined. So this is a constraint for the arcsecant. Okay, so now, but anyway, we will have 2x over x squared, because the absolute value of x squared is just x squared, square root x to the fourth minus 1. And that leads us to 2 over x square root x to the fourth minus 1. Okay, so that's your final answer. Now, the third example is similar, but it will be a little bit more difficult. Because we will have a product rule. Okay, we'll have a product rule to deal with. So the example will be x cos arc cosine of 2x. Okay, so the derivative of this, the derivative of this is going to be, using the product rule, we're going to differentiate the x first, so x turns to 1, so we will have 1 multiplying the arc cosine of 2x, and then plus x times, now we're going to differentiate the arc cosine of 2x. So the arc cosine of 2x is going to be negative 1 over square root 1 minus, and you're going to square not the squared here, you're going to square not the x, you're going to square the 2x. Right? So you have to put the 2x like that and then square it. And also taking the chain rule here, right? Because now you have to differentiate the 2x, so you have to multiply it by 2. Okay, so that leads us to our cosine of 2x plus, well, actually minus this time, yeah, minus 2x over square root 1 minus 4x squared. Okay, so there's, you cannot really, you can't simplify this any further, so this is your derivative. So I hope that you found this video useful. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video.